Hi, welcome back to my system administration tutorial. This video I'll show you how to use the ls command. So to know more details about the ls command, type man ls. Now you can go through the details of the man page to know about each and every parameter. So what I'm going to discuss here, I'm just going to discuss about the important options used in the ls command. Okay, type ls and see what is happening. When you type ls, it would list all the files and directories which exist in the present directory. Okay, you can see here some color coding is used. The blue colored ones are called as the directories and these are called as the files. Fine. Now type the next command, ls-u. There's a huge difference between the first one and this one. Let's see. Now you are getting more number of files, and including the files starting with dot. The file starts with dot are called as the hidden files. You can list every files, including the hidden files. That's the meaning of U. So that has listed each and every file which exists on the present working directory. Fine. Now I have another option which is called as UF, ls-uf. This would list out only the files exist on the present working directory. You can see that the normal files as well as the hidden files, everything got displayed. Okay, another beautiful parameter we have ls-l. This basically provides a long list. Now you can see here there are various options available here. Now the some details, okay, here's something, and okay, which is basically provide a long list. Now what's the meaning of this? Each and every column has its own meaning. So now first let's start from the first column. The first column, you are able to see some set of bits. These bits represents the type of the file as well as the permission of the file. The first bit represents the type of the file. So if you see a hyphen, you can understand that it is a normal file. Look at here, it's a normal file. If you remember the previous color coding I was talking about, you can understand it's a normal file. When it is start with D, it's a directory. Okay, you can understand that it is a what directory. Now if something start with L, you can say that is a link. Probably there is no link file available. Yes, fine. Okay, that's not an issue. Okay, and also you have different other files available in the Linux. Basically you can understand something like what's the meaning of bash and what is meaning of d. So this is the majority of the file which exists across all of your directories. Okay, next you can see that other permission bits. The first three bits represents the permission of the user, or otherwise called as the owner. So what the owner can do? The owner can perform read and write. So here R represents read and W represents write and X represents execute. These are the three different permissions basically for each and every file. Now this is applied user wide. Now the first three bits represents the permission of the owner. Next three bits represents the permission of the group. The last three bits represents the permission of the other user. The next column, this represents the number of links. So how many number of links exist for this particular file? So this file is 1 and the next one is 2. And here somewhere down you can see there is some 17 links are there. Now the next column shows who is the owner of this particular file. And then column next to that shows who is the this user belongs to which group, the group of this particular file. Next it's followed by the size of the file, and then it was modified, and finally the name of the file. So when you say ls-l, this brings out the whole details, something like the permissions, the type of file, links, who is the owner and the user, the group of the file and the size of the file, and so on. Now when you look at here, something like, you know, it's not very easy to understand, okay, what's the size of the file. So to know that, there's another beautiful option available, ls-lhatch. Now you can see that that becomes more human readable. H stands for human readable. Now it shows in some units, instead of saying in bytes, it says M for megabyte, K for kilobyte, G for gigabyte, and so on. So max of I have, you know, M size files. Okay, fine. This is a beautiful option, and we want to, this gives more readability to whatever you are printing by using ls-l. Fine. Next, we have another option called ls-li. If you type this, you can see your long listing prefixed with one number. It's a bigger number, and if you closely look at these numbers, each number is of a unique number. Now, why this unique number, and what is this? This is called as an inode. So inode is a number which is used to uniquely reference each and every file available in your directories. Now, it's again, we can say inode is otherwise, you know, in depth, if you talk about, we can say it's a data structure which is used to store the attributes of your file and so on. Okay, anyway, you can just keep it like inode is a number which is used, which is unique, and it is assigned for each and every file, so that you can access your files by using inode rather than mentioning the file name. So that is internally used by the system. Fine. Now we have another option, ls-ln. Now you can see this. Is there is any difference? Yes. So look at previously. So here the username and group name was printed. Rather than using the group name and username, the ID of the user and ID of the group is printed here. So that's a beautiful option. Yen. So this is sometimes this may be required. When you are dealing with scripts and so on, this might be useful. Yeah, I have discussed almost all the frequently used options of ls. Have a nice day. Thank you for watching.